వెల్కమ్ టు ఈపీజీ పాఠశాల. ఐఎమ్ దేవన్ కుమార్ కూడా అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ సెంటర్ ఫర్ సోషల్ జస్టిస్ అండ్ గవర్నెన్స్, స్టార్ట్ అండ్ సోషల్ సైన్సెస్. టుడే ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ ద మాడ్యూల్ ఆఫ్ రూరల్ మైగ్రేషన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ రూరల్ డెవలప్మెంట్ కోర్స్. దిస్ మాడ్యూల్ హ్యాజ్ ఏ అబ్జెక్టివ్ రేంజ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జెక్టివ్స్, ది ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ రూరల్ మైగ్రేషన్, definitions of rural migration and various theories of migration will be elaborately discussed. Where further, the patterns of migrations and importance of rural migration and their livelihood patterns will be discussed. Further, how it is impacted in urban India and further in rural India, that will be elaborately discussed. Importance of rural migration. The migration is one of the important component in rural livelihood, where it is giving livelihood to number of people. Migration has a positive and negative impacts. Positive impacts, obviously it will give livelihood to the people, but negative impact, where many people leave their native and they go to the urban setup, and they psychologically and emotionally they will be away from their home place. So that will give these negative psychological stress. Further, in India, census defines the migration, rather the census captures the entire pattern of migration, how the people mobility, what is the definition of migration, what is the duration of migration. In this way, rural urban migration is increasing over a period of time from that is captured in census. Since 1991 to 2001 census, 21% of the rural migration is increased, that is recorded in census. And similarly, in 2011 and 1991 to 2001 census, the net rural increase of migration recorded 21%. Whereas 2001 and 2011 census recorded 24%. So in the decade, there is a net increase of 3% of rural to urban migration. So what do we understand the migration? Migration is, it is constant move of people from one area to another, but it is defines in census, it is a largely the administrative boundary. If one person is moving from one administration boundary to another, but it is, if you move from one area to another very short period of time or a small area of distance, it is not counted as a migration. It is just a movement of people from one place to another for their different affairs. But it is, in sociologically or migration theorists understand that people move from one place to another, a change of milieu is considered as an important migration. Change of milieu means the change of environment along with the change of dwelling. It is important component, or it is considered as one aspect of migration. So migration is people mobility one place to another. It is largely captures the census data, where it captures the census data. It captures the census where it is recorded rural to urban migration. Largely, the census captures the migration. So, but the sociologically and theoretically, we understand the migration in a very scientific way. It is defined by certain geographical locations or administrative boundaries, but short distance of migration we cannot consider as a migration. So what is definition of migration? Migration, we in a general parlance, we talk about migration is something move from one place to another, one individual or group of people move. But in a scientific definition, the word migration, it is derived from the Latin word migre, which means change of residence. The simple meaning of migration, it is a shift of one place to another place, the physical shift of one place to another place, it is considered as a migration. But UN defines, the migration is defined as a move from one migration defining area to another, usually crossing the administrative boundary. Administrative boundaries, it can be district or it can be state or it can be one country to another, that is considered as migration. According to Weinberg, he defined the human migration is a changing of place of abode permanently or temporarily for an appreciable duration of period. So duration of period is also important. So duration of period is not considered as migration. It is a it is a significant number of days or significant number of months is considered as migration. So, but migration is a phenomenon which takes as a general process of migration, but the person who moves one place to another is called migrant. Migrant is a person who changes his usual place of residence from one place to another is a migrant. Migration is a process. The person who takes or removes the migration is called as a migrant. Migration has a different process and different patterns. It is national migration within the country and international migration. People move one country to another country. The international migration is a different, the international migration is a different parlance and different terminologies are used. Among them, the two important concepts, immigration and immigration. Immigration is a concept which refers to a person move from one place to another where the movement is defined. The immigration is refers to person who moves from one country to another. The in migration is defined where he reaches the place. In other words, the immigration and immigration refers to respectively to movement out or movement into particular territory. For instance, a person from US coming down in India and settle to India, he was regarded as an immigrant from India, immigrant from US, and immigrant to India. For instance, migrant leaving from United States to India and he want to settle in India, he was regarded as an immigrant from US and immigrant to India. As I said earlier, migration is a different processes. It is national and international. It can be within the district, within the state, and international level. I already explained the international migration, the immigrants and immigration concept. But when you talk about Indian context or within the territory of the country, there are other concepts are used, in migration and out migration. In migration is a person who is leaving one place to another place and reaching the place is defined as a in migration. Whereas the out migration person is who is leaving from his own place to other place where he reaches, it is called in migration. Where he moves from the origin, it is called out migration. So it is equal to emigration is equal to in international concept the in migration refers to emigration and immigration refers to the in migration. As I discussed earlier, the international migration concept are immigration and emigration. Similarly, the in migration and out migration are used in within the country boundaries. So in international level, the immigration is equal to in migration and out migration refers to equal to immigration. So in this way, students should not confuse with the concept of in migration, out migration that is used in within the national territory, within the country boundaries, where the emigration and immigrations are the concept are used for international migration. There are many other concepts also used in the subject of migration when we study or understand the entire process of migration. The words like the place of origin and place of departure. The place of origin and place of departure refers to person who is moving from one place to another. The place where the movement is taking place is a defined or known as a place of origin or place of departure. Similarly, the person who is reaching the place or destination, arriving at a particular place, it is called destination or place of arrival. So the person who is moving is known as a origin or a departure. Similarly, the person who is reaching a particular place where the movement is terminates is known as place of arrival or it is destination. Similarly, there are migration in different processes or in different patterns where the different streams of migration we need to understand. The migrant who moves from one common origin to common destination within a given period of time in a given geographical locations within the administrative boundaries. It is it is known as migration streams. Similarly, their migration pattern is another concept which is often used in migration studies. It is configuration of the process of migration of streams during given period of time within the given geographical boundaries or within the given administrative boundaries. So the migration stream is a process where a person moves from one place to another place, or a group of people move from one place to another place. It is in a given period of time, it is known as migration stream. The pattern can be different pattern. It is largely defined in a time intervals. Time interval, it can be short term, or it can be long term, it can be seasonal, or it can be very circular. So the stream is a movement of one group and one individual or a group of people where to in search of livelihood or in search of job. But the pattern is a more or less it is understood in a time interval period. There are various theories are dealt in understanding the studies of migration. Among them, E.G. Ravenstein prominently appears. By considering the importance of migration, its social impact and its economic impacts and negative impacts, he studied very closely situating the England situation in late 19th century. In this entire study, he developed two papers, what is called Laws of Migration. Those papers are published in 1885 and 1889. In these papers, how the migration, what are the deciding factors of migration he understood? What are the factors which leads the migrant to move one place to another, whether it is for economic migration or whether it is for accumulating of income migration, or it is forceful migration in search of livelihood? He expounded this phenomena of migration by using simple numerical methodology, demonstrated the pattern how the migration taking place. This laws of migration as a basic foundation theories, theoretical understanding of the migration, where any student who want to understand the theories of migration, one should not miss the laws of migration which is studied by E.G. Ravenstein. Followed by E.G. Ravenstein, Everett Lee criticized E.G. Ravenstein's laws of migration theories. Instead of the numerical method of calculating the determinant factors of migration, he identified four factors of migration. Those are associated with place of origin, associated with place of destinations, and intervening obstacles and personal factors. These four factors are largely as a leading factors for migration. Place of origin, where there is no economic opportunities or employment opportunities, so people, that defines the migration. Or the place of destination, where destination also attracts the people, where the livelihood opportunities will be available, so they leave the origin to reach the destination. And the intervening obstacles is also leading factors of migration. And personal factor, whether it is economic migration or it is education migration or it is forceful migration in search of livelihood. So these four factors are comprehensively studied and theoretically dealt by Everett L.A., where he criticized the earlier theory, E.G. Ravenstein's theory, and he propagated these four factors of migration. So he divides the existing forces of influences of migration, and how rather he divides the migration in different calculated methods like pluses and minuses, where pluses and minuses can be waived, where if the balance is zero, then the migration doesn't yield any benefit. If pluses are more, then the migration yields benefit, so the migration can be taken place. But minuses are more, then the migration cannot be taken place, where in the destination he would not get better yield, or he cannot be benefited even if the migration take place or the migrant who goes to the place, the migration doesn't yield a better perspective. So based on this concept, he developed the full and foose factor. The full and foose factors are very important factors of migration. It is not only the origin which drives people to migrate one place to another in search of livelihood, but the full factors, the urban with the development of the urbanity or industrialization, where people have economic better off or economic opportunities, where they will that attracts the people or that pulls the people, so the people will migrate. So these pull and foose factors are important factors of migration. Apart from the origin and destination and obstacle forces and the personal forces, there are another theories to theorize the concept or the theory of migration. He postulated the simple two-sector model, where the agriculture is a lower, if the agriculture is a very low productivity, it is not yielding better productivity, or there is no economic gain, then this surplus labor from this agriculture sector can be transferred into industrial sector that is much more developed, where that the surplus labor can be reduced. In the agriculture sector, where many people are involved in the same process of production, but the yield is not has economic gain. So the surplus labor can be transferred into industrial sector, where the surplus labor can get economic benefit. When they are involved in the same agriculture process, their economic gain is largely considered to be zero, or it is sometimes negative. So the surplus labor can be transferred into industrial sector. That is the Arthur Levy's model is propagated the theory, but it is further expanded extensively by Professor Gustav and Reynes, and further associated by John Feeney. So these three people, Levy's, Feeney's and Reynes, are discuss or theorize this model, the two sector model, economic opportunity model, where the agriculture production is very low, so the surplus labor is involved there, but their production is not yielding better income or better economic gain, so they can be transferred into modern, much more developed and industrial sector. So the traditional sector of traditional sector of agriculture has a zero productivity or a very low productivity. So this surplus labor can be transferred to industrial sector. So their economic opportunity can be enhanced or their income can be enhanced. There is another model called Todaro model, who claims the migration lies in the incorporation probability to income differential model of migration. Todaro postulates the migration rural urban differential with expectation rather than actual earning of income. So it is not something that somebody has a definite calculation whether he will get the job in where the place which place he goes, or how much earning he would be calculated, or what is the particular wage that he will be getting. So it is more of expected, based on the expected calculation, one pattern of migration or individual migration takes place. So there is no definite defining things. If the migrant goes to one place and then he get the job immediately, this much of amount of money or this much amount of salary would get. So it is more of expected rather than actual earnings. The basic behavioral assumption model consider in choosing either one between the rural migration or urban migration within the demand of the labor market, based on the labor market demands. So based on this premises, the expectation premises, he propagated the theory, saying that one individual goes or takes place a migration from one place to another based on their expected calculation. So the expected gains has a different functions. It is existing rural urban real wage differential based on their skills or their educational experience and other categories, whether it is a female or male, based on their, you know, experience, based on their education, qualifications, skills, his earning can be different from those people, those who have lack the other qualities like skill or education. If the male person goes to in an industrial construction work, he would get more wage. But if female goes, then the work can be not that much of hard work cannot do female. So the wage can be reduced to her. So in that way, this expected income is different from one place to another. Also, it different from one individual to another, different from educated people and also skilled people. And the probability of new migrant, whether it is getting the job immediately when reaches the destination. So this is also a factor. So many people, they go in search of work to different places, but they don't get the work immediately. So they look for work based on their contacts or based on the place where the work is available. So this way, the migration is more of uncertain, where they go with expectation. It is not only the work they will get immediately when they leave, when they reach the place, or what kind of a job they will get, what kind of work they will get, and what kind of what amount of wage they will get, that is not certain. So it is completely with expectation they will go. This model is propounded by Todaro. Further, Todaro argues that without introducing the probability variable, it would be extremely difficult to explain the continued and often accelerated rate of migration. In the probability model, only the migrations take place based on their expected calculation. Todaro model is criticized by Jayant Brahman, where Todaro's theory, the expected calculation migration, may not applicable in many places. He came up with an understanding rural-urban migration with an Indian example. He studied in Gujarat, in South Gujarat, saying that the migration can take place not based on expected calculation, there is uncertainty of wage and getting the job, getting the wage and getting the work also, but it is often not the expected calculation. The migrant moves one place to another in search of work. It is more of the forced migration, or it is the economic compulsion that pushes people to migrate in search of work. So according to him, the migration labor driven, it is not only the high level of aspiration when compared to other non-migrant person. So the migrant who goes one place to another, it is more of the economic necessity, where if he is a landless, he is not getting work in their place of origin or nearby area, so he will go because of economic necessity. He will not have an aspiration of a better off compared to other neighbors who is largely having put security of their house. They may not tend to go migration. So it is not as compared to, it is not what he wants to achieve by looking the individual is economic terms, but it is more of forcing him to go to the place in search of work to meet the survival, day-to-day survival. So Jayant Brahman criticized the Todaro model. It is may not applicable in many ways with expected calculations of migration. It is more of forceful migration, where people move from one place to another in search of work to meet the day-to-day basic needs. The rationality of migration is not based off on strategy of maximizing the aspiration, but it is more of survival strategy. So Jayant Brahman, he conducted a study in 1985 witnessing South Gujarat, where he understood how the rural migration is taking place one place to another. It is more of an act of survival strategy. People go nearby areas to in search of work, to get the wage, to fulfill their day-to-day basic needs. Marxist and neoclassical theorists also largely theorized the migration pattern and migration processes. Marxists focus the structural factor being responsible for migration of rural poor. They viewed that the system, the structural system of society, where the industrialization or the capitalist to exploit the rural labor, so the people they migrate one place to another place. So they use the concept of proletarization and depeasantization. These are the concepts which used by the Marxist, saying that the people are labor class who migrate one place to another in search of work, because the capitalist or industrialist and the landlords and the money lenders who exploit them, they don't get the work within their own place, so they migrate. And the depeasantization concept was further delineated, saying that the peasants, the peasants' land was grabbed through different processes in the industrialization process or in the larger development process. So they lose the land. So the peasant or the farmer completely uproots his livelihood. So he moves one place to another in search of work to meet that his basic needs. That is further studied Jain Brahman only. Jain Brahman study is a more or less Marxist theorization. So he studied how the proletarization is happening in migration, and also how the depeasantization is there in the migration processes. On the other hand, neoclassical economists saw the migration is a much more optimistic and other way around. It is more of economic better off way, where the mobility, the rational choice of migration taking place because it is the industrialization and developing, people want to go and walk, but there it is other way around. What Jain Brahman talking about, people have losing their land, people have losing their job in their own place. So because of the capitalist or the industrialization approach, so in this process they lose the land and they lose their job, that is what the people migrate. But it is the neoclassical understanding is different. It is counter to the Jain Brahman's the Marxist way of understanding. So the labor migration is largely the neoclassical people, they understand the migration is more voluntary choice. It is for economic better off or economic gain. But the Marxist understanding of migration, it is more of forceful migration, when they lose their economic livelihood system, and they get uprooted their economic livelihood system, that is what they move, they take place, the migration take place and they get the livelihood. So in the larger understanding of migration, there are two factors, that pull factors and pull factors delineate the migration. The pull factors is more of economic opportunity, where the opportunities pull the people. But the push factors, it is more of poverty, backwardness and underdevelopment, where they don't get opportunities of work in their own place to meet the day-to-day needs and their survival. That is where the migration takes place. So in this context, it is largely studied based in this way. In Indian context, Desinger see extensively studied the migration and the process of migration, its impact of migration. She highlighted saying that migration is taking place. It is largely unorganized migration that contributes 60% of GDP. And the unorganized workforce is 22% of unorganized workforce contribute to migration. And they work many low-level profile jobs. That is where the 92% of the migrant workers and unorganized workers are contributing in Indian economy. So their contribution to GDP is 62%, their workforce is 92%. Neo-Malthusian perspective of rural migration. Neo-Malthusian scholars saw the migration is more of ecological refugees. The ecological refugee concept delineates saying that the natural calamities and natural catastrophes have that leads to migration. There will be drought and there will be crop failure, there will be cyclone, the entire crop will be uprooted, there will be declining of rain, or there will be decline of agriculture opportunities, decreasing production, even the fluctuation of market. These are all the ecological refugee concept largely delineated the Malthusian understanding of neo-Malthusian understanding of migration, where the people land will be fragmented over a period of time with the drought and flood, natural calamities and natural catastrophic processes, and that there will be demographic pressure where population will grow, and there will be deforestation and soil erosion and other. This ecological refugee concept is dealt the neo-Malthusian perspective understanding, where the challenge of migration, it is not only the economic opportunity, or it is not only the full force factors, but it is more of ecological refugee concept. It is largely the natural calamity and natural catastrophe that push the people in search of livelihood. There's the different theoretical understanding of the migration. What we largely see is a full and force factors are that leading to migration. Migration is not only one factor that responsible migration, but both of the factors. It pushes the people from one place to another because of their poverty and backwardness, and pull the people where the opportunities are available to them. The economic opportunities would be much more perspective, where they can get the job, starting from construction worker and industrial labor, or many other range of work people. That way they see the work is available there. In that calculation, the people migrate one place to another in search of their livelihood. Migration pattern and significance of rural livelihood. Contemporary rural migration of Indian rural poor is overwhelmingly circular in nature. Where the household relatively have food security and better economic opportunity or better income, they don't migrate. But sometimes such households also migrate, saying that the one individual, if goes one place to another from economic better off household or relatively food secure household, that their migration has a economic opportunity. But people, those who lack the opportunities, or they don't have food security, or they don't have economic opportunities, their migration is more of survival, and it is in search of work to meet their basic needs. Further, the migration from one place to another, largely it is taking place in a bigger cities like Bombay, Chennai, Hyderabad, Kolkata. So their living conditions will be suffer. They don't get proper amenities, housing, electricity, water and all. But in rural area, it is a different problem we see, where migration is largely male dominated, where male migrate leaving behind their wife or children and old parents at home. So the woman who takes the entire burden to manage the entire household. So she need to take care of the children, she take care of their agriculture product, entire work, and she need to take care of their cattle. So entire work is taken care of by the woman and children. So in that way, the socialization of their children, upbringing also affects. And women, until the remittances come from the urban or the migrant who sends, then she need to manage the household by looking work. She need to find out work, maybe to the landlord or an agriculture work. In that way, she also get disturbed, or she also psychologically, she gets effect, and there will be vulnerability of sexual harassment. So in that way, the rural problem is much more different than the urban problem. This is the module which explained rural migration, where it is supplemented with the e-text, where it is further elaborately discussed. That if you go through the e-text, all the theories and all the concepts which elaborated discussed, that will help you in understanding comprehensively this module. Thank you.